Thomas Jefferson once said, when a man assumes a public trust, he should consider himself public property. What galls me about this is this waste, this extravagance, in contrast with a lot of people I met at home in my state during this last recess who are struggling to make ends meet. For example, in eastern Montana, there's something called the Bakken Formation. It's heavily impacted by oil and gas development. The police force is stretched so thin, they can't begin to deal with all the issues. And police officers start at 40,000, and their salary is 40,000 a year. And they see $800,000 spent. What's going on here? There's a little town of Culbertson I visited. They're just scratching to try to get money for a sewage system, trying to piece it together here and there. When they see this waste, they go, what? We could use that $800,000 for a sewage system in our little town. Otherwise, we can't afford it. We can't finance it. After that, a little town of Ingomar, Montana. It's a very small population, about two hands, trying to save their post office. The rent is $700 per month for that post office. And they see $130,000 for 8 pre-conference trips to Las Vegas. You know, it's just galling. It's absolutely galling when you see what the dollars could otherwise be spent for, and just for legitimate purposes, where people are really struggling. And I just tell you that I think Senator Cardin touched on it, as did Senator Johansson. I agree with him. There's something rotten in Denmark. Something's not quite right here. It's not just this. There's got to be a lot more. And I very much credit you, Mr. Tangerini, for taking over here. I have a lot of trust in you. I think you're the kind of guy who's going to straighten all this out. But it's going to take a lot of work, a lot of work. It can't be something we can just deal with, you know, not paper over, but just kind of do it moderately. Can't do that. You've got to go to the core and get this thing really, the culture problem rooted out at GSA. And I just thank you so much, Madam Chair, for this hearing. But it's, I just urge you and demand of you almost as a person working for 1 million people, that this is what they want. This is what my employers want. You know, I work for all those folks I talked about. You work for all those folks I talked about. Everybody at GSA does. That's the public trust that we have to honor.